Hey y'all, hope you're doing well. So today I decided to talk a little bit about interpersonal conflict, arguing, fighting, whatever, with other people. I came up with this because I was trying to think about what are things that a lot of people can relate to, things that can occur under stress. A lot of us are very stressed right now. And one of those things is just generally, I think, I'm not citing a statistic or anything, but I think when people are under stress, they're just more prone to getting into arguments, to fighting with each other, etc. So I thought I would say a bit about one of the kind of ways that a fight, an argument, whatever can end. And that's when it kind of doesn't end. It just kind of stops, right? Whether the one person storms off or something, whether the two people just kind of pretend it never happened, etc. I think we generally tend to view that as like an unhealthy way to deal with conflict. And so I thought I'd just present a different perspective on that as a little nugget today. So I think that in some cases, it can be fine or even healthy actively to take that approach, to just walk away from an argument. Now, that being said, I think there's a right and a wrong way to do that, if assuming it is the right approach in a given situation. And I actually think this can be a good approach. Whether we're talking about a silly argument, sometimes when people are stressed, it's not so much that there's a real problem that needs to be resolved between two people. It's just that they were both stressed. They happen to be around each other, wrong place, wrong time. Other times, it's a real thing that there's a real issue that needs to be resolved. Those two people need to talk that out, come up with some kind of compromise or solution. And I think the thing to try to gauge whether this could be a good approach is basically whether that argument that's happening is getting anywhere. Is it actually resolving anything? Is it being productive? Or are the two people just mad and, screaming at each other, whatever it may be, arguing, whatever? In that case, if we're not getting anywhere, walking away could be like the best possible thing you could do. Since you're not making anything better and maybe even making things worse. Now, that being said, here's the critical piece. This is what differentiates an unhealthy walking away from a healthy walking away, is that you have to then come back, right? That can't be the end of it. It has to at least be coming back and saying, maybe it's one of those ones where it's actually not, there's no real problem. It can be, okay, I've had 10 minutes to kind of cool down. Now I'm thinking, what were we even, what was this? I feel like we should just kind of like drop this and pretend it never happened. If the other person agrees with you and you guys can kind of let that be, great. Try that. Give it a shot. See if that actually works for you. It might be fine. But if it's something serious that needs to be resolved, you can take that break, calm down, collect yourself, come back. And maybe you can make that something that's a little more productive. Now, one last little piece to this is that we all handle this kind of stuff differently, and we all have different approaches to managing our own distress, conflict with others, etc. One common dynamic I see is that one person in an argument, we'll say in the context of a relationship, a romantic relationship, one person is the person who needs to walk away and like kind of cool down. The other person is someone that has a lot of trouble with that. That makes them very anxious. They feel like they really need to like resolve that argument, okay? And they may even like chase after the person who's trying to walk away. And it's really tough for them to not do that. So the walking away thing can still be really effective in that situation, but the person who is the walk awayer must come back, in that case, to establish that trust, to allow the other person to be okay with sitting with their distress, knowing that if they wait a little bit, the rest of the conversation is going to go better. You know, and if this is like a romantic relationship, this is just an example. You can apply this to any relationship, but in the context of a kind of a long relationship where you're continuing to talk with that person, even set a time. Like, it's going to be 10 minutes. That person literally can set their timer for 10 minutes when you walk away, and you're going to set yours, and you know you've got to get back by about 10 minutes, you know. Just some musings, a little more scattered than maybe some of my other nuggets here, but just something I thought was really relevant to pretty much all humans. Hope it's helpful. If you have any questions about it, don't hesitate to comment or email me or whatever. Again, hope you're all doing well. Have a great one. We'll see you around.
This is an informational video that is not intended to replace professional treatment for specific mental health problems or symptoms. If you're having thoughts about harming yourself or others, call your therapist or doctor right now. You can find contact information and call your nearest HSO location to schedule an appointment at www.healthsourceofohio.org/locations. You can also talk to someone now by calling the suicide hotline at 1-800-273-8255.